Welcome back to Prachi Foundation online classes, and this is my third video on class 11th mathematics chapter number 1 set. And today we are going to discuss about the types of set. What are the types of set and what properties they contain? And if you have not watched my other two parts, go and watch so that you can understand it better. Now we start types of set. So there are how many types of set? See, first is called empty set. Second is called singleton set. Third is finite set. Fourth is infinite set. Fifth is equivalent sets. And sixth is equal sets. Now we go one by one and we will try to understand that what are these sets. Now the first set, empty set, or we also call it a void set. Student, as per the name, you must have understood that why it is called empty set, because it has no element. It has no element, or it is represented in roster form by an empty braces. You can see there is no element, or we represent it by phi. So wherever you look this sign phi in the set, you can understand that that set does not have any element, or you can say that is an empty set or void set. So a set which does not contain any element is called empty set, or we denote it by empty braces or phi. Now the second type of set is singleton set. Single, you must have now read it, single. So you can understand that this set only has only one element. Like A is a set which contains only one element, which is 5. So how many element it has? Only one element, a single element. So because it has a single element, it is called singleton set. Or else you can write, suppose minus 5, or you can take 10, or any number. So you will see that in each of the set you will get only one element, this singleton set. Now students, let's come to the third type of set, that is finite set. By the meaning of the word, you can judge that a finite set has a finite number of elements. Finite number of elements, it means that you can count the elements. Like for example, if I say A is a set which is less than, A is a set natural number of natural numbers. It is a set which is natural number less than let's say 10. So you can easily judge what are the natural numbers less than 10, and these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So these are the natural number less than 10. So you can easily count its elements, like it has 9 elements. And there are many more examples of finite set. Let's say even numbers less than 50. This is also a finite set, because even number less than 50, you know that 2, 4, 6, 8 and up to 48. So this is a finite set because it has finite number of elements. You can easily count how many elements this set has. Now let's come to the student, infinite set. So it is opposite of finite set. Here we cannot count, we don't know actually how many elements this set contains. For example, let's say if I say A is a set X, where X is an element of R and X is between 0 and 1. What does it mean? It means this is a real number which comes between 0 and 1. Now we know that between two rational numbers, there are infinite rational numbers. 0 is a rational number, 1 is a rational number, and x is a number between 0 and 1. We know that between two rational numbers, there are infinite rational numbers, and it is also called real number. It means irrational numbers will be also included. So, we can say that this set is an infinite set because it has many elements and we cannot count how many elements this set has. Also, for a simple example, let's say all the natural numbers, all the even natural numbers, there is a set A which contains all the even natural numbers. Now we do not know what is the biggest natural numbers, there will be going on and on. So it has infinite number of elements. So this set is called infinite set. Now let's come to the cardinal number. Cardinal number of finite set. What is this? Cardinal number of finite set. A finite set, it is represented by always small n and then there will be set A. N, it means number of elements. So cardinal number of finite set shows that this set has how many elements. This is called cardinal number of finite set. And then we come to the equivalent sets. When we compare two sets, we find, suppose we have a set A which has element 1, 3, 5 and 7, and there is another element B which has element 2, 4, 6 and 8. See, both contains different elements. This has all the odd numbers, this has all the even numbers, but the cardinal number of A is equal to cardinal number of B. It means number of element in A is 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 element, and number of elements in B also 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So both set have equal number of elements. So when both set have equal number of elements, we can say that cardinal number of A is equal to cardinal number of B. So we can say that both are equivalent sets. A and B are equivalent sets. Now students, let's go to equal sets. What are equal sets? Let's say A is a set where the elements are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And there is another element B which has element 5, 4, 1, 2, 3. This is written like this. Now the order is changed. But you can see the elements are same. A has 1 as element, B also has 1 as element, 2, 2, 3, 3. Both have the same elements but the order are changed. So when two sets have the same elements, same value, so we can say that these two elements are equal sets. These two sets are equal sets. We can say that A and B are equal set because both have the same element. No matter in which order you write the elements, but if you both set have the same element, they will be called equal sets. So students, hope you are getting the topics, and if you are getting the topics, please like and subscribe our channel, and also write your comments that in which topic you want to see the videos, or if you have any difficulties, you can write us. Thank you for watching Prachi Foundation.